iPhone 13 tips and tricks. Let's go. Now, first off, we're going to start with the camera app. Now, you can put any icon you want on the lock screen. So you can long press in the camera app there. However, a quick way to access the camera from your lock screen is just to swipe left and you're already inside your camera without even opening your phone. Now, let's say you don't want to change modes, but you want to record a video and you're in photo mode. You just long press the shutter button there and you have recorded your video. It's as simple as that. So this is just a quick tip. If you don't want to change modes, but you're in photo mode, you can record a video from there just by long pressing that button. Okay, the third thing now, whilst we're in the camera app, let's say you want to burst photos, or you want to capture burst photos. Just long press the shutter button and swipe left. And then, as you can see there, I've already captured about 20 odd numbers of pictures there. So if you want to just capture burst mode of pictures, you just long press, swipe left, and that will do you good. Okay, so the fourth thing now, I have this box in front of me. It's written, I assume, in Chinese, then beneath it in English. In camera app, in the live mode, you can actually capture text. So here I selected that text, then it will give me an icon on the bottom right, where if I click on it, you show the text. I can select the text, even translate the text whilst in that mode. And obviously, this is just the same word or phrase, but in different languages. The next thing is an app called Magnifier. Now, Magnifier can bring text that's far off or very close. So you just open it. Then you can just zoom to the required level and it will show you the text very closely. So this is quite a handy feature for your iPhone. And the zoom level here is greater than the camera zoom. So this is quite handy. Now on the next tip, let's go to settings and accessibility. Now whilst we are there, we will open touch and back tap. Now back tap, you just tap the back of your iPhone. And there's a double tap and triple tap option where you can put anything you want. For me, I put screenshot. So right here, I'll attempt to do a double tap. And you can see it actually captures a screenshot. So you can put anything else that you want as a shortcut here. So this is quite a handy feature, especially if you don't want to be touching your phone a lot on the front or touching buttons. So this is quite a great feature. Okay, the next thing, whilst we are still in accessibility, we are going to look for another option called live speech. Now, live speech is essential for people, for example, with disability. Let's say someone cannot speak. They can just select the options there. These are phrases I had already typed, but you can also type other phrases and it will speak the phrase that you have typed. So this is essential for, let's say, people who cannot speak, people who want to communicate in other ways using your phone without even installing any app. You can do this with live speech on your iPhone. Okay, so the next thing now, we are going to open another app, a default app, which is called Measure. Now, Measure is quite handy because I've seen some people use an app for this, like a downloaded app to do this exact thing. But for the Measure app, you can actually measure a certain item in terms of length, width, whichever. And you just click the point there. on the laptop. As you can see, I'm clicking the endpoints of my laptop from east to west, and basically west to east regardless. So basically it will show you the distance that is the node rule life sense. So there it shows me it's 37 centimeters. So it's a rule line some odd centimeters. And yeah, it's a quite a handy app which you can use as well. Then we move on to the notes app. Now this is quite a handy feature as well, because you can scan documents inside the notes app. So obviously here, I'm not selecting any document in particular, it's just a laptop. But if you select a laptop, as you can see, it puts it there. If you want to add another page, for example, which I did inadvertently there, you can also do that. Then you just say done, and it actually saves your document that you have scanned. And actually save it also in different formats as well. So this is quite handy, especially if you want to scan documents and you don't want to install any other application to do that. You can actually scan documents using your iPhone. Then lastly, whilst we are also in the notes app, let's say you want to correct, let's say you write this long text and you want to correct a certain letter which is amongst that. Now naturally you do that, right? And it's quite frustrating, to be honest, because you know sometimes it's not as accurate as you might want it to be. However, you can also use the space button, where you just long press the space button and just navigate to the exact position you want to edit. So trust me, this is a very handy feature, because I was also looking for this. Then as a bonus, in Safari, this is also something that I've learned you can also do. So let's say you want to request a desktop site in Safari. You just click that icon there. Then it will give you a number of options. And from that number of options, you can then go and request desktop site. And once you do that and confirm, it will take you to the Google desktop site for that, or whichever website you have opened. So this is quite handy as well. Now these are the tips and tricks in this video for your iPhone 13. If you have any other tips and tricks you want to see, put them in the comment section down below. If you like this video, like, share, and subscribe.